This is huge. FMCSA actually puts this on their official FMCSA.gov newsroom official site, right? And basically what they're stating is they are putting Monique Trucking out of business. And Cruz Mendoza, a few weeks ago, lost control going over 70, 80 miles per hour, you know, and basically dropping steel pipes on the ground. And I killed the driver, ran into six vehicles, and did not have a commercial motor vehicle license, right? Did not have a CDL. So there are so many problems with this. And, you know, Cruz Mendoza got deported. And we thought that, okay, the FMCSA was just going to give Monique Trucking a slap on the wrist. But that is not the case. For once, they did what they were supposed to do, and they shut down a company that was not safe for the public. You know, and it was really because of three things. One is, if you're a carrier, you're going to have some type of program to test your drivers, you know, for drugs and alcohol, right? And send them to go get tested. The company did not have that. Number two, they had so many hours of service violations, right? And three, they were hiring drivers that properly were not legally allowed to drive a CMV, commercial motor vehicle. So overall, thank you, FMCSA, for doing the right thing and shutting down a trucking company that was making other drivers and companies look bad. Let's get to today's video. Let's talk about this. We'll read into the newsroom of what it says, you know, and we'll go from there. But overall, I think this is big news. You know, this is what the FMCSA needs to do, right? Really look at the people doing it wrong and stop punishing and harassing the ones that are doing it right. What's going on, Mutha Truckers? Welcome to Mutha Trucker News. This is big reports right here because, you know, the FMCSA newsroom, their official FMCSA.gov, I'll put links down below so you could read this whole article here from FMCSA. But they actually report that they are shutting down that California-based motor carrier that had hired Cruz Mendoza. Remember the video? I'll put the overview at the end if you have questions about this, but basically a truck driver lost control, dropped pipes, steel pipes off his truck, and hit five vehicles and killed one person. And Cruz Mendoza did not have a CDL. And so I haven't heard FMCSA making a point out of a company in a long time, but basically the gist of it is for safety reasons and for hiring drivers without a CDL. So let's get into this right here. Okay, so the title reads, FMCSA declares California-based motor carrier an imminent hazard to public safety. Says here, on June 11, 2024, an employee of Monique Trucking was operating a commercial motor vehicle when it failed to properly maneuver around another vehicle and caused a crash involving six vehicles. One of the drivers of the vehicles involved was killed and others were injured. Okay, so following the crash, FMCSA conducted a compliance investigation and concluded that Monique Trucking is non-compliant with the Federal Motor Carrier Safety Regulations and has been cited with numerous serious violations of the FMCSA's in an investigation and in roadside inspections. Specifically, Monique Trucking failed to have in place a controlled substance and alcohol use testing program and was not registered in the FMCSA Drug and Alcohol Clearinghouse. So, if you're a carrier, you're going to have a program to test your drivers. And that's the first step that got Monique Trucking out of business. Failed to ensure that the driver employed met commercial driver's license standards. 49 CFR Part 383 failed to comply with House of Service of Drivers requirements. 49 CFR Part 395 and failed to comply with the vehicle maintenance and inspection standards. 49 CFR Part 393 and 396. So the investigation revealed that the leadership of Monique Trucking demonstrated a lack of knowledge of safety regulations despite receiving multiple roadside violations in the 2 years preceding the June 11 crash. So FMCSA has concluded that Monique Trucking lacks safety management controls to ensure that its drivers are qualified to operate CMV and its drivers operate in its CMV safely or that its CMV are in safe operating condition. The imminent hazard out of service order states violations of the FMCSRs substantially increase the likelihood of death or serious injury to Monique trucking drivers and motoring public and establish the entire motor carrier operations imminent hazard. So, failing to comply with the provisions of the federal imminent hazard order may result in several penalties up to $33,000 for each violation. Motor carriers may also be assessed civil penalties of no less than $13,300 for providing transportation in interstate commerce without operating authority registration, and up to $18,758 for operating a CMV in interstate commerce without a U.S. DOT number registration. Knowing and or willfully violations may result in criminal penalties. So, overall, Mother Truckers, you know, Monique Trucking is out, and FMCSA actually did their job. And, you know, you can say what you want, but if they're not conducting safety, they did not have a program in place for their testing, drug and alcohol testing, and they're hiring people that are not qualified to drive a CMV. So overall, they did the right thing. You know, this is the FMCSA that we need, the one that's protecting the drivers, the motoring public, you know, and everybody in America, right? And so overall, my truckers, comment down below, but I thought this was big news because the FMCSA is actually doing what they're supposed to be doing.